During this lesson, I will talk about fractional shortening and E-point septal separation as a little bit more objective way to assess the left ventricular function.
In order to obtain fractional shortening, you will need to get a right parasternal short or long axis view and place the cursor across the left ventricle just beyond the tips of the mitral valve leaflets and between the papillary muscles in the M mode on the short axis view. The resultant M-mode tracing allows measurements of the chamber diameter in both systole and diastole. On this image here, you can appreciate an LV internal diameter during diastole. It's depicted as EDD, and during the systole, depicted as ESD. End diastole coincides with the beginning of the R wave on ECG, and end systole with the end of T wave on ECG. Once you have these two measurements obtained, you can calculate fractional shortening by using this formula. End diastolic diameter minus end systolic diameter divided by end diastolic diameter and multiplied by 100%. In other words, you will determine by what percentage LV diameter decreased in size during systole as compared to diastole. Normal fractional shortening in dogs is about 25 to 45% and in cats 30 to 55%. Large and giant breed dogs tend to have lower normal fractional shortening, closer to 25-30%. There are several limitations of fractional shortening measurement. First, Penton dogs often have excessive motion of the cardiac structures, which can lead to incorrect impressions of depressed systolic function. Also, we know that both LV and RV are contracting not only in short axis, but also in long axis plane. Therefore, single plane assessment of the fractional shortening may underestimate LV function. In addition, this measurement is highly dependent on preload through the inclusion of LV internal dimensions in diastole. Although LV internal dimension during systole depends on afterload, it has less relation to preload and by itself can be used as a measurement of myocardial function. I want to reiterate that the eyeball method is more important in diagnosis of causes of undifferentiated shock in an emergency setting. Fractional shortening should be used as an additional tool in case of equivocal results of eyeball method. An operator should always remember about this method's limitations and about its operator dependency. Motion of the anterior leaflet of the mitral valve can also be used to assess LV contractility. In a normal contractile state, the anterior mitral leaflet can be seen in the parasternal long axis view touching or closely approaching the septal endocardium in early diastole. The degree of excursion of the mitral valve directly correlates with the contractile state of the left ventricle. As cardiac contractility decreases, the distance between the mitral valve and septum increases due to a poor diastolic LV expansion. There are several pathologic conditions that will decrease EPSS even in the face of normal LV function. These conditions include mitral valve stenosis, hypertrophied interventricular septum, and aortic insufficiency. These are two examples of a patient with a normal systolic LV function on the upper side of the slide and poor systolic function are the two images at the bottom. By looking at the two upper images, you can appreciate that the anterior mitral valve leaflet is almost touching the septum during end diastole, indicating good LV function. The two images at the bottom of the screen show very large distance between the anterior leaflet and the septum at end diastole, indicating that LV is barely expanding and filling with only small amount of blood during diastole, given that there is no mitral stenosis or aortic insufficiency. M mode is used to document and measure the degree of mitral valve excursion, known as the E-point septal separation. To obtain this measurement, the M-mode cursor is placed over the tip of the anterior mitral leaflet. As the mitral valve moves during diastole, the M-mode tracing reveals a characteristic pattern of two repeating waves. The first is the E-wave, which reflects the initial and maximal opening of the valve to allow passive filling of the left ventricle. Immediately following is the A-wave, which is usually smaller and corresponds to left atrial contraction. The EPSS is the minimal distance between the E wave and the septum and is normally less than 6.5 millimeters in dogs. One human study demonstrated that emergency physicians are able to accurately estimate ejection fraction using EPSS, highlighting its value in identifying patients with abnormal contractility in certain situations. This is an example of M-mode obtained by the point of care ICU machine in order to measure EPSS on one of our canine patients. You can appreciate here that the distance between the E-point and septum is minimal and obviously less than 6.5 millimeters. There are a few veterinary papers describing EPSS measurement in dogs. The bottom 2014 JVIM paper showed that EPSS of greater than 6.5 millimeters in Dobermans was 100% sensitive and 99% specific to diagnose DCM in this breed. EPSS can be utilized by ER clinicians in case the results of eyeball evaluation and fractional shortening measurement are equivocal and an extra piece of information is required to determine the LV function of this patient.